Last episode, we chatted about Brian Trottier, who came in at number 38 in our top 60 list. This week's article on NHL.com that will accompany this episode of 60 Diamonds will cover numbers 30 through 21. Here we'll do a deep dive into a couple of those picks, but first joining me to discuss are David Satriano from NHL.com and NHL great Pierre McGuire. Pierre, thank you for joining us today.
Adam, it's awesome to be here. The NHL Draft, one of the most important days on the National Hockey League calendar.
Yeah, this has been such a fun project, and we got Pierre, so we know we're going to have some great knowledge today coming through.
Absolutely. So we know how the list came together. 13 writers and editors from NHL.com took their time to determine who are the 60 greatest draft picks of all time. Guys, let's get into it. Some great picks in this group from numbers 30 to 21. Number 27, Pavel Bure, sixth round pick in the 1989 draft, the Russian Rocket, one of, if not the fastest skater of all time. Just a remarkable player, the 60 goal seasons. He nearly carries the Vancouver Canucks to the Stanley Cup in 1994.
Yeah, you know, to me, he was one of the most feared shooters in the 90s, just scoring 50 goals. Every time he was on the ice, you had to look out for him. And, you know, of players that played 700 games, he's third behind Mario Lemieux and Mike Bossy in terms of goals per game, 0.62. So that tells you how good of a shooter this guy was.
100%.
And what really stood out to me about Bure, just the speed he attacked the game with. It just, I mean, Pierre, you've been around a long time. Have you ever seen a player skate as well as Bure to do what he did?
In the modern era, the only guy I can compare him to is probably Connor McDavid. But at that time, at that juncture of the National Hockey League history, there was nobody faster.
One of the guys that really stood out to me in this group is Bobby Clark, came in at number 23. Being in Philadelphia, I have the fortune of seeing Clark both as a player through highlights and being around him as a manager. And all the things he did, he set the template for what a Philadelphia Flyer is, that mix of grit, skill, toughness, led the Flyers to 2 Stanley Cup championships as a player, but that's who Philadelphia fans think of as a great player, a guy who brings that skill set.
The thing that really impressed me about Bob Clark, Adam, I gotta tell you right now, he made everybody around him better. He made the trainers better. He made the coaches better. He made his wingers better. He made the team's identity better. Bob Clark made the Philadelphia Flyers better, and that's why they're a legacy team.
Absolutely, and if you look at our list, number 21, Alex Ovechkin. You know, he comes into the league in 2005-2006. We're coming out of the lockout. We need faces to power the next generation, and Alex Ovechkin brought that face, and here we are 18 years later. We're still talking about Alex Ovechkin as an elite player in the league. Yes, he was a number one overall draft pick, but how do you not have a list of the 60 greatest draft picks and not put in the player who could very soon be the greatest goal scorer in the history of the NHL?
Well, the reason that you don't have him in is if you forget him, like I did. Look, this was a very tough project. I just overlooked him because I was kind of going way back drafts just to kind of bring guys who are lower than number one picks. But no excuse. He should be on the list. You mentioned he's going to be the greatest goal scorer in history. 50 goals, 30 goals, 15, 16 seasons in a row. He's still going. Doesn't look like he's going to stop anytime soon. So, yes, you're exactly right. He has to be on this list.
The first time I ever saw him play, he was 14 years of age. He was playing with a Russian travel team through Toronto. And Scotty Bowman and I went to go watch him play, and we were overwhelmed by his size, his strength, and his ability to shoot the puck. Then the next time I saw him was the 2003 World Junior in Halifax. He was a 16-year-old, dominated that, and the Russians won a gold medal.
Sure.
And the rest is history. You know, the right-hand shot on the left-hand side of the ice, the one-timer. Everybody knows it's coming. Nobody can stop it. It's amazing. So you talked about some man that was really smart. You talk about coming out of the lockout, that the league needed faces. Mm-hmm. Don't forget, Mario Lemieux had retired. Wayne Gretzky had retired. Who was going to carry the league? There was a void. Ovechkin and Crosby come in at the same time. Pittsburgh versus Washington, both in the Metro division. And it's mayhem. And it's awesome. And it's fantastic.
And it's still going on.
Yes, sir.
That's the best
100%.
Part. 100%. So there were some great names in this batch. Pavel Bure, Patrice Bergeron, Bobby Clark, and of course, Alex Ovechkin. Dave, Pierre, thank you so much for joining me on this episode of 60 Diamonds. Don't forget, this countdown will culminate with the release of numbers 20 to 1 on June 24th at 7 p.m. Eastern, airing on NHL Network. For Dave Satriano and Pierre McGuire, I'm Adam Kimelman. Thank you so much for watching 60 Diamonds, the greatest picks of the 60 NHL drafts.